You make a point that you have covered hunger crises in Africa before, and to you it feels like we're in the same place and nothing has really changed. Explain that out a little bit for us.
Yeah, it's very sad. There was a huge famine in Somalia in 2011, and after that, the aid industry had vowed to never let this happen again. I mean, how can you have a famine with people dying of hunger, lack of food, lack of clean water in the 21st century? It really frustrated people. But now we're back in the same situation. Somalia is right on the brink of a massive famine. I was just in the area a few weeks ago where I met many people who were starving. There's this problem of a lack of clean water that's leading to very preventable diseases like cholera, and that's wiping people out in camps of starving people. And at the same time, you have three other famines that are going on in Nigeria, in South Sudan, and in Yemen. So I get the sense that the aid community is totally overwhelmed. And on top of that, you have the U.S. government talking about cutting support to the United Nations and for foreign aid. So it's, to sort of use a cliche term, a perfect storm of factors that are really stressing people out and could lead to many deaths across a wide swath of territory.
You talked about the UN being strapped and countries not giving as much as they once did, including the United States, which sounds like it wants to pull back some of its aid to countries around the world for many different things. Let me ask you what you think about the fact that, you know, the focus really has been on the Middle East, on Syria, on Iraq, and what has been happening there, and more worries about the folks that are in those situations. Do you think Africa is often just left behind and forgotten?
Well, I think that's a really good point. I mean, right now there are so many crises around the world. It feels like we're, you know, in a world of conflict and despair. I think that really is pulling attention away from this part of the world where I'm in. I don't know. I mean, Africa traditionally gets a lot of relief and gets a lot of attention for humanitarian causes. There are enormous UN peacekeeping missions in Congo and Darfur and South Sudan. The amount of resources that are directed to this part of the world is quite substantial. But it's very difficult to respond to these different crises at the same time. And each is driven by its own dynamics, by warlords in one place or an Islamic militant group in another. And I think there's just kind of a discomfort right now of how are we going to adequately address these different problems, get the food in, help people so they don't die of preventable diseases. And I'm not hearing any real, positive answers so far.